Hello everybody, this is Lloyd from FPGA for Student. Today's video is a tutorial on how to do image processing using Verilog on FPGA. I already posted a Verilog code for image processing on FPGA. The link is in the description below. However, there have been a lot of questions related to this project, so I decided to make this video to give you guys more explanation on the code and to guide you how to run simulation for the code. In this video, I will use this image to process in Verilog. For example, I want to reduce the brightness of this image. How can I do that in Verilog? Because the image file here is in bitmap format, but Verilog cannot read bitmap format. So what we can do? So we will convert this image in bitmap format into hexadecimal file because Verilog can read hexadecimal data. So how to do that? So I will use MATLAB to convert the image in bitmap format and convert it into hexadecimal file. So this is the hexadecimal file that we convert from the bitmap image. So this hexadecimal data will be used in Verilog to read and process. This is the code for reading and processing an image. So in this code, I will read the hexadecimal file of the image and then process it using three different operations. The first operation is brightness control. So in this operation, I will be able to reduce or increase the brightness of the image. Another operation is threshold operation, and the final operation is inversion. So to select the operation to process the image, you have to go to the parameter code. So in this code, I will select the operation for processing the image here. For example, I want to reduce the brightness of the image, so I will select the brightness operation. So I will deselect it and then comment this line. So I will get the brightness operation. The other two lines here are to define the input bitmap file and the output bitmap file. So the input bitmap file is already converted into hexadecimal, right? So this file will be used for reading and processing. The output here, I define it as the output.bmp, which is the bitmap file we want to see. So now let's go back to the reading and processing code. So in this code, there will be two parts. The first part is reading and the other part is processing. As you can see here, we have many parameters here. This is image width. This is image height. This is the folder which you have, you put the image hexadecimal file, right? This startup delay is to create the vertical synchronizing points. This delay is to create the horizontal synchronizing points, okay? This signal can be useful for creating a Verilog model of an image sensor or a camera. So in the case that you want to test your image processing algorithm with your real-time image or video processing, so this signal can be useful. This value is to use in the brightness operation, which you want to reduce the brightness or increase the brightness of the image. The threshold is used for the threshold operation. The sign here is used for brightness operation. The sign equal to 0 means I want to reduce the brightness of the image. Sign equal to 1 mean I want to increase the brightness of the image. Now let's go into the input and output part. You see the clock of the system. This is reset. The reset is active low. These are the signals that I mentioned. Vertical, horizontal, synchronizing points, right? So these signals are useful for real-time image processing. These are the image data that we read from the image hexadecimal file, right? In this video, I am using two pixels at the same time. That's why we have a six data here, because each data has three different components, which is red, green, blue, right? But in your case, if you want to read one pixel at a time, then you just remove these three data. But you have to modify the code inside. This is the output done. To say that, okay, the processing and reading part is done. So we can start to write the output image and see it. So let's go into it. These are the internal signals. So this is the code for reading image. So the image already converted into hexadecimal and it put in the int file. And we read using the system task read mem hexadecimal, right? And we save it into the total memory variable. This variable will have the size of the image. So as you can see here, if you want to change the size of this image, you have to change the size of this memory as well. So because I want to read one pixel for processing, and each pixel had three different components, which are red, green, and blue, so I will save the image data into three separate memories for red, green, and blue. Okay? So that I can read one pixel at a time. This is the FSM machine to create the vertical synchronizing points and the horizontal synchronizing points. So this is the image processing part. So when the data is valid, it means that the horizontal synchronizing points is 1. We start to process the image. So if we select the brightness operation, we will use this code. Here you can see that the sign equal to 1, it means that we want to increase the brightness of the image. So to increase the brightness of the image, we add more value to the pixel. So the higher the value of the pixel, the brighter the pixel, okay? Similarly, if the sign is 0, it means that we want to reduce the brightness of the image. So we deduct the pixel. We reduce the image data, the image pixel, so we can make the image darker. So every pixel, I reduce it by a value here. Okay? There are so many lines here because we are reading and processing two pixels at a time. And each pixel, we have three components, red, green, blue, and blue. Okay? So now let's go into the invert operation. So invert operation basically is that if the image is bright, you make it dark. If the image is dark, you make it bright. Okay? So here I convert it into grayscale and then I do the invert operation for two pixels at a time. This is the threshold operation. So I also convert it from RGB data to grayscale and then I do the threshold operation. It's pretty simple here. So if the value is higher than the threshold, then I will make the pixel white. Otherwise, I will make it black. Okay? So basically, there are two values, black and white. If it's higher than the threshold, we make it white. If it's lesser than the threshold, we make it dark, or we make it black. Okay? So That's the processing part. So let's go to the writing part. So in this part, we will write the image, the processed image, into a bitmap image so that we can see the result. Okay? This parameter, image width, image height, is the infinite to define the output name, output image name, right? This is to define the number of bytes of the BMP header, the bitmap header. I will explain this one more later in the code. This is the clock reset up to low. This is the horizontal synchronizing pulse. So basically, when this pulse is high, it means that the data is valid, so we can write the data into the image. Okay? These data are the data that we process, right? We want to write this processed data into the image. Write done here is the flag to let us know that the writing part is done. Okay? So now let's go into it. So this is the header. The header is very important because if the header is wrong, the image cannot be written. Okay? So if you change the image size, you have to change the header. Okay? So the details of the header, you have to go to this website and you change based on the configuration of the header, and it will change based on your size as well. So you have to be careful with this header. Okay? So in this case, I'm using the size that I use here, the image here. So I use this header. Okay? So when the data is valid, which means that the horizontal synchronizing pulse is 1, I will start to save the processed image, right? After processing, I will write the image into the image file, right? So this is the code for writing image. Writing the processed image data into an image in bitmap file, okay? So now go to the test bench. So this is the test bench for simulation, right? So basically, I instantiate the image reading code and image writing code together. Okay. Okay, now let's run simulation. So here I want to select the brightness operation, right? I want to reduce the brightness operation. So let's see how it's working in simulation. So the output image will be written to this file. So now let's see. Okay, so basically you need to run 6 milliseconds. Okay, after the writing part is done, you close the simulation, okay? And then you see that the image will be available. So this is the image that we already reduced the brightness. So it means that it become darker, right? So this is the original image, and this is the image that we posted. We make it darker, and I think it's work. Okay. So now let's say we change to the invert operation. See how it works. Run simulation again. Run 6 milliseconds. Okay, it's done. Then I close it. And then I will open the output image. Okay, this is the output image for the inversion operation. Okay. Another example, I will run the threshold operation. Okay. Run simulation again. I will run 6 milliseconds. Okay, it's done. Then I will open the output image. Okay, so this is the output image of the threshold operation. So it works. So that's it. That's it for this image processing project. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe so that you can see more upcoming FPGA tutorials or projects. See you next video. Thank you.